For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. We stand within weeks after a hurricane. There will be more storms, according to the Bible. There will be the plague of no water turning to blood. There will be the power of Satan. But right now, you are living and breathing. And that will come to an end one day. Maybe today. Today is the day of righteousness for you. Behold, now is the day of salvation. For God loves you so much that he gave his eternal Son for the payment of your sin. And you are a sinner because the Bible says the wages of sin is death, and when you die, it will prove that you have sinned. You can clean the grounds, but what must you do to clean your heart and your soul by the sins that you have done? It is not something that God approves of religion, because religion cannot clean. And when you go to religion, it's like putting wood up on your windows. The windows are still there. You just hit it. You need something that will get rid of your sin. You need something that will purchase your sin. And that is the Lamb of God, which takes away the sin of the world. That Lamb of God is the Lord Jesus Christ. For by his righteousness do you have the access to God. For Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. We stand here preaching the gospel that you are going to die, and you will face an afterlife. That afterlife of the Bible speaks about a heaven and a hell, nowhere else. Nothing else speaks about the afterlife of someone living today. Either go to heaven or you go to hell. And the only access to heaven is by the shed blood and the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, that he died according to the scriptures and was buried and arose again the third day according to the scriptures. Now, all around us today, there is destruction. Property.
Hi, Martha.
Has been destroyed. And yet you can fix your property. But when you die without Jesus Christ, the destruction will never be fixed. And the Bible speaks of it as tormenting. There will be pharmacists in hell, but you cannot get medicine from them. There are doctors in hell, but they will not be able to give you a prescription for your relief. There are psychiatrists in hell, and they will not want to hear your problems because they are problems and torments of themselves. There is no relief in hell like you can get relief from a hurricane. will never, ever be found. And Jesus said, I am the water of life. And since Jesus will never be in hell, you cannot have an attribute of Jesus in a place where he'll be absent. If you think that this tiny hurricane was a problem in your life, you're going to face a greater problem called hell, which you cannot escape. The lizard and that woman will not be able to help you in hell. Because the insurance that you need today is death insurance. And that death insurance, the premium was paid on Calvary's cross by the pure blood of God, Acts 20:28, by Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone. It is tragic that lives have been destroyed in Texas. It is destroyed that that lives have been tormented in Florida. And that the Caribbean has been completely wiped out by God's storm. And yet the most tragic tragedy of torment will be the fact the day that you enter hell without Jesus Christ. Ladies and gentlemen, God made that hurricane. And God made hell. You cannot stop a hurricane, but you can stop yourself from going to hell today. It is not at a hardware store. It's not at a pharmacy. It is at the foot of the cross where Jesus Christ died for your sins. Ladies and gentlemen, let me play back what happened last week. Oh, we see a hurricane coming towards Florida. Run to the stores! Get everything you want! Clear the stores out! My God, a hurricane's coming! Board up! Do this! Do that! Hurricane's coming! But let me tell you what's happening today. The wages of sin is death. You will die. You will go to hell without Jesus Christ. And your attitude is, will you shut up? Will you get out of here with that junk you're preaching? You treat a hurricane more efficient than you do the Word of God. Maybe that hurricane was a warning of God and yet more to come, according to how I read the Bible. When God's people sinned the area of Judah, God sent them all kinds of warnings. When God dealt with Egypt, he sent them all kinds of warnings. And like 2017, September 16th, you won't listen and you won't give a heed to what God has to say. And you'll drown in the waters. Your city will be tumbled down and burnt and destroyed. That's Bible. Our nation was built upon God and Jesus Christ and the Bible. Now this nation is built upon booze and sex and stupidity. You have got children coming out of schools who cannot read their name on the diploma, and yet we're a wonderful, great nation. And we take that Bible out of the schools. We are a nation where people will shoot each other. People will kill each other. I will take a bucket and make a with the inmates running the place. You got a government that cannot help you, and yet Jesus Christ is reaching out. Come unto me, all ye that are heavy laden. Come unto me, ye that are burdened. Come unto God. You're going to die. Come to my son. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Truly goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, for I have believed on the Lord Jesus Christ. Friends, we're preparing you like they prepared you for Hurricane Irma. And they may be preparing this country for Jose, maybe, we don't know. But Americans will react more to a hurricane than they will the Word of God. And I'll tell you about a hurricane. They don't know what that hurricane's going to do. That hurricane can make a change that will change everything. And yet the Word of God is sure. The Word of God is pure. The Word of God is right. All 100% of the prophecies of Jesus Christ's first coming are fulfilled. They are written and checked off with the blood of God. Acts 20:28. Did that, done that. When Jesus met with Moses and Elijah on the Mount for Transfiguration, did I do that?
Yep.
That fulfilled.
Yep.
Lord, Master, Jesus, everything has been fulfilled by the prophets and by the law. And then he went to Calvary. And if everything was fulfilled by the first advent of Jesus Christ, you better believe the Bible says if you die without Jesus Christ, you will be in hell. As much as a baby will be born in Bethlehem. And you will be born in hell for eternity, as much as not a bone of him will be broken. It's prophecy. You need to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God's eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. If a truck pulled up right now and said, we got water, we got food, all you had to do is go through a hurricane. Open up the back, here you go, take it. Then you go running. You would run like a hobo going out there for a sandwich. And yet we stand here and preach Jesus and you just go about your business. If I put a table out here with free hamburgers, I would not be able to get them out as quick to get around the table as quick as you would grab them. And yet we preach the gospel, we preach the salvation grace of eternal life, eternal hope. And your attitude is, I wish he'd shut up. Why didn't you call the weather forecasters last week and say, shut up? You don't know what you're talking about. You don't know anything about a hurricane. Shut up. And yet that's the words out of your mouth here at Daytona Beach Farmers Market. And what I'm telling you is not a prediction, it's prophecy. And I'm just trying to deal with your lost soul, that's it. I'm not going to get into tribulation period. I'm not going to get into 666. I'm not going to get into the mark. I'm not going to get into, you know, the 15 heresies of this religion. I'm going to get into the fact that you're going to die one day. When you die without Jesus Christ, you will burn in hell. today. Churches are hellish until they die. Just because you're offended doesn't mean that God's going to change everything because of your belief. God doesn't care what you believe. I believe Mary could save your soul. God says, no. Jesus said, I am the way. Not Mary, sorry. Or if I go out in the name of Allah and kill infidels, sorry, Jesus said, I'm the truth. There's no Jesus in Islam, so that must be a lie. Allah is a lie because there's no salvation through Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who is God. Well, I'll go out and peddle magazines. Jesus said, I'm the light. And you cannot obtain salvation by a Jesus who is not God. See, Paul writes to us and tells us that there's other Jesuses. There's Jesuses who are not God. There are Jesuses who were just good teachers, good men. There's a black Jesus. There's a Jesus Christ when you smack your fingers on the engine block of your car. And yet there's only one Jesus that will save your soul. The Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world. Wave your hands if you love Jesus. There's a heaven and there's a hell. What must you do to go to hell? Just reject Jesus Christ and do whatever you want to do. What must you do to go to heaven? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. What about what my church says? What your church says is not what God says. You do know, according to Corinthians, that there are ministers of Satan in pulpits. There has been, and there will be, especially on TV and the radio. Women are not to usurp authority over the men. You cannot go against the Bible and expect to be right with God. God does not have a book in heaven saying, okay, this is what I say, and this is what America believes. That's hogwash. If we are a Christian nation, why isn't the Statue of Liberty holding a Bible in New York Harbor welcoming the immigrants? No, the Statue of Liberty has become an idol, which is an abomination to God. What is sin? Rejecting the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved, that's sin. You know what the other sins are, what other people do. I don't have to name a sin. You already know what sin is. But there's one sin that will cast you to hell, and that's rejecting Jesus Christ as your Savior. Behold the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world. If you have not been washed in the Lamb, you are not saved. I said a prayer. That may not be salvation. Now, I'm not going to say it is, I'm not going to say it's not, but you better check. Because the Bible says in Romans, for with your heart man believes unto salvation, righteousness. For with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. You got to make sure that your heart repented, and not just your lips. Your lips can speak something, but what did your heart say? True salvation is of the heart. You will come to a time in your life that you're going to die. No matter who you are, no matter what race you are, what sex you are, you will die.
You have that choice. God gives you a free choice to either go to heaven or go to hell.
And what happens to you after death is based upon what you do before you die. If you have done nothing of belief and repentance by the blood of Jesus Christ, you will not go to heaven. If you've gone to church, you were baptized, you did this, you were a good person, you gave money, blah, 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 you'll go to hell. The Bible says there is none good, no, not one. You are never good enough to get to heaven on your own merit. That merit is done by the blood of Jesus Christ.
Scientists have gone to God. You know that in the
gospel.
Says,
go in all the world and preach the gospel. That Christ died for our sins.
Moses tells all the
according to the scriptures.
To wash their hands.
And he was buried.
Dead, they have to come in contact
with blood.
They have to
and he arose again.
That people actually wash their hands. After a surgery, people were dying because they went from one body to another.
In order to get to heaven on your own merit,
washing their hands in bloody water,
you have got to be more righteous than Jesus Christ.
But in the Bible that was written back in 1611, it said,
you have to be better than Jesus to get to heaven on your own merit.
The manuscripts are written thousands of years.
And many of you are saying that. I go to church. Well, then your church is better than Jesus Christ. I give money. Then your checkbook is better than Jesus Christ. I was baptized. Then the water is better than Jesus Christ. You've got to come to God by Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone. That's it.
Have you ever had it?
Salvation is of God. Salvation is of Jesus Christ. The Bible says in Psalms, God doesn't trust his saints. And when an angel came to Cornelius, the angel said, go get Peter. I'm an angel, but I can't do anything about your soul. Isn't that interesting? And when that angel showed up to Cornelius, he didn't come in his breakfast cereal. a man that can preach the gospel. Simon the sorcerer. Oh, let me buy that laying on hands. Can I get in by money? And Peter told him, said, you're a child of the devil. Listen, we're going to tell you week after week after week after week, as long as God gives me breath and ability to be here. It comes down to simple words. Nothing's going to get you to heaven but Jesus Christ. That simple. You don't need to know my name. You need to have the name of Jesus Christ. You need to have your name in the Lamb's Book of Life by Jesus Christ. Don't you dare ever show up to God and say, well, have God say to you, why should I enter into heaven? Well, I went to that church at the farmer's market in Daytona Beach. God's going to scratch his head when he says, Daytona Beach, what's that? Because there's only one city. Yeah,
very good, very good. It's like that storm just went through. Okay. And then pick the echo up north. Yeah. He took care of us well.
Hey, brother.
All the blessings of the food in our freezer did not get destroyed. That's God.
Don't come to God and say, hey, listen, I heard that man you spoke to. Because I can't do nothing for salvation. I had to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, too. I am just being obedient to the Bible, but outside of that, I'm a sinner too. There's no other man that can get you to heaven except Jesus. There is no other man that can absolve your sins but Jesus. I'm going to go in the telephone booth and I'm going to tell this man all my sins. And what has he done that he has told no one about? Can that man be trusted with little boys? My Savior, my God, Jesus Christ can be trusted with everything. Because he's the righteous. The gift of God. And he's able to save you to the uttermost. He's able to take the sins that are in your life and wash them. Where God would say, what sins are you talking about? To put your name in the Lamb's Book of Life and be signed, sealed, and delivered. By Jesus Christ. These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that you may know you have eternal life. 1 John 5:13. No belief, no eternal life. John said, he that has the Son has everlasting life. That's good. He that has not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abiding upon him. Someone's going to look at your dead body. And where are you going to be? There is no RIP in hell. You are not resting in peace in hell. Sorry. This is another lie of Satan. And the comforting of Satan could damn your own soul. Sometimes you gotta be hard. You know, there are some bones that if you break, the way you break it, the doctor's got to re-break it in pain. And this is a hard message. And yet there is a hell. You won't go there without Jesus Christ. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Saved from what? Hell.